having a wonderful week. Wonderful, yes. Magnificent week.
Yes.
And now it's time to rest.
Yes.
Rest your body, your mind, your soul,
yes,
your spirit.
In Christ.
Amen.
So all you have to deal with today is the Word of God.
Word
amen.
Of God,
amen.
Yes. Yes. Let it marinate. Let it permeate in your mind. So we're going to go ahead and open up with the prayer as we always do. This is
yes.
Brother Jacob here.
Yes.
And along with myself, Sister Rika, you're listening to the Happy Sabbath Day AM show today, March 23rd. And we're going to go ahead and open up a prayer.
Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to come on this morning, this the day you have blessed, the day you have sanctified with a great meaning that's taken us to the first resurrection, that points to your first resurrection. And we thank you for that understanding. That's why we rejoice in this day every time it comes around, because we know what it's pointing to. And then all the saints say amen,
amen,
amen, amen, amen.
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 Go right into our scripture reading today. It's going to come from Psalms 19, verse 7. Psalms 19, verse 7 through 10. And it says, "The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is pure, making the wise simple. The statutes of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandment of the Lord is pure, enlightening the eyes. And the fear of the Lord is clean, enduring forever. The judgment of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. More to be desired are they than gold." Wow.
Amen.
Yeah, than fine gold. Sweeter also than honey, and the honey. Home. Praise God.
Amen.
Look at all the benefits of the Lord. Especially in the 7 verse 8, enlightening the eyes. How many times have you read something in the scripture and you just went?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
your eyes
have just been enlightened.
Yes. There are so many things that we learn from His Word every day. Remember,
yes.
It says in the Lord's Prayer, "Give us this day.
Hey.
Our daily bread." That's
yes,
the bread that we eat. And speaking
yes.
of bread, you know, we're coming up on the new year. We're coming up on the Feast of Unleavened Bread. So I hope you guys are getting prepared for that spiritually.
Less bread with leaven in it.
Yes. And that's
more
both physically in your home and spiritually within your heart. Amen. 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 Changing that inner man that we have. And not only
changing
for ourselves, but changing other people, getting them to the gospel and understanding that change they need to have for themselves. We're going to get right into our gospel praise, And as we're speaking of change and converting, let's get right into J. Moss. This is good and bad, because while we were yet sinners, God still showed His love toward us, according to Romans 8 and 9. So let's go right into J. Moss. This is good and bad. This is the remix, house mix. Remix, hope you guys enjoy.
You loved me through my good. You loved me through my bad. You loved me through my good. And you loved me through my bad. Jesus. You didn't erase my future because of my past. I'm glad you loved me through my good. And the bear.
You loved me through my good. You loved me through my good. Who else would have done that? You loved me through my good.
Yeah. what we deserve.
You love me through my good. You love me through my good.
Through all of my shortcomings.
You love me through my good.
And that's my favorite right here.
Behold, therefore, the goodness and severity, of God. On them which fail severity, but toward thee goodness, if thou continue in his goodness.
Yes.
Otherwise, thou also shalt be cut off.
Yes, fearful God.
So that's a big if. That's the big word if. Yeah. Two-letter word if.
It was mad impact.
Yes. We want to say happy Sabbath to our listening audience. Happy Sabbath, brothers and sisters, Brother Chris. Happy Sabbath to you and your family. Happy Sabbath also to Sister Betty Sue Ware. Happy Sabbath. Happy Sabbath to Nyla. Happy Sabbath also to Hattie. Sister Hattie, happy Sabbath to you and Nyla. And she said, whoop, whoop. Sister Hattie said, whoop, whoop with the hand praise emoji. Sister Betty said, all right, happy Sabbath day, Albert. Let's get it. The fire emojis, music note emojis, hand praise and air emojis. Happy Sabbath, Sister Marlise. She said, blessed and happy Sabbath day. Also, happy Sabbath to Sister Britt and her family. She said, Sister Betty Sue Ware said, Lord, thank you for keeping on loving me despite myself. You are so awesome, God. Come on, let's have church.
Okay.
With the 3 exclamation points. I'm sorry, 4 exclamation points.
Yes, sir.
And she said, who is that singer? And Sister Hattie said, Jay Moss. Yes, it's Jay Moss. Go ahead, put this song in there, and it's the remix version. It is the remix version, and it's called Good and Bad, that song. When I heard that earlier this week, I said, oh yeah, we got to start this praise up in here with this song right here, because in another life, you know, I was like a gospel fitness instructor, you know, because it make you want to do your N1. And 2 and 3, right? The fitness workout for God. So moving on to the show, guys. Again, happy Sabbath to our Bible Christians moment. Our Bible Christians moment for today. And as you guys know, as the world called March the Women's Month, right? And then even had on March 8th, the International Women Day. Yeah, that was something that, about 2 years ago, I started seeing in the grocery stores, the international women, and they had all the women of different
colors. Wow.
Yeah, it's a thing. And so they have that one specific day out of the whole month where they're, like, celebrating the nationalities of women and stuff. But we decided to take this moment for this month of March to talk about the powerful women in the Bible. And today we're going to talk about Jehoshabeth. mm-hmm. or Beth, yeah. if I'm saying that right.
Yeah.
The woman who secured the royal line of the Messiah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, she had a huge role. Mm-hmm. She had a huge role. And if you guys know that you got the southern kingdom and the northern kingdom, and that southern kingdom is, you know, the tribe Judah, which, you know, the lineage of Christ. And so during that period, you had most of the righteous kings inside of that, the southern kingdom right there. So Jehoshaphat was Joash's aunt, a sister of Hazael. Perhaps she too was a daughter of Athaliah. She was. And if you guys know the story about her, she was a wicked queen. Okay. Mm-hmm. She was the only queen of Israel at that time, or Judah, I should say, specifically. And but she was kind of like the Herod of that day, because yeah. she didn't want anybody to try to usurp her throne. It's kind of right. like an Uncle Scar and Lion King situation,
yeah. Yeah.
but considered wow. a woman. He's like, oh no, nobody getting this throne. But anyway,
reverse.
Yeah.
I mean, almost similar. The analogy is very.
Yeah. Yet when she saw the carnage taking place, she ran into the nursery, talking about Jehoshaphat, and picked up Joash as a small infant and hid him so that Athaliah's thugs were unable to kill him. But Jehosheba, which is another of a name, the daughter of King Joram's sister Hazael, took Joash, the son of Ahaziah, and stole him from among the king's sons, which were slain, right? And they hid him, even him and his nurse, in the bedchamber from Athaliah so that he was not slain.
Mm-hmm.
So her incredible bravery, again, her name is Jehoshabeth and also Jehoshasheba, it's both interchangeably, was bravery in the Almighty God's name. Her unshakable faith ultimately secured David's lineage, because we know that through that lineage, Christ came through those line of kings.
Mm-hmm.
It's remarkable how God orchestrated events to fulfill his prophecy. Yeah. He perfectly matched up person, a place, and time so that King David could be beget a royal line from which the Messiah, the King of Kings, would come. Isn't that amazing, guys? And I'm going to just mention that it's the first time in the Bible where I actually saw where Jehoiada, she's also, Jehoshaphat is also the wife of Jehoiada, and he was priest at the time. And so while Joash was growing up to become that next king, he was basically in line telling people and securing like the whole bed chambers. Like it was like the first time I kind of seen like this sense of having security. Like you have to, we want all the men and to draw their swords. If anybody come by the throne, if anybody come in the courts, I mean, it was like the whole place was surrounded to make sure that Athaliah at that time did not take little Joash, because he was the next in line.
Aww.
Yeah, isn't that nice? So she was really instrumental in taking her nephew, which was her own mother that was doing the whole.
Wow!
Yeah, imagine that. Yeah. Your mama up there being the whole Ursula from Mermaid and just the bad guy and, the whole time.
And that's why I understand who Israel is physically.
Yes.
You see some situations amongst us, you'd be like,
yes, yes. And so she had a choice.
Yeah,
she had a choice. And guess what?
That bad.
And guess what? That is an example of preservation.
Yeah,
she saved.
She preserved
that young child so that the mother, her own mother, would not kill off the lineage by which Christ had to come. Because remember, Christ called the beginning. He called
the end from the beginning.
There you go.
Yes.
And so with that being said, it's remarkable of her story.
Yes.
And do we have a scripture for that? Where she could be? Where is that? Because I know it's in Kings. I'm going to go ahead and find that for you guys.
Let's bring up another cut.
Yes. Now, this is from one of the kids. They had recommended this on last night's. Our Sabbath Day Bright Learners lesson, and this was Kalani's. Happy Sabbath, Kalani, if you're listening. We're playing your song today. This is Wonder Working by All Creatures, Wonder Working. And how many of us have that testimony that God is a wonder working God?
Amen.
He is an all present God. And he's so many things in your life. So this is Wonder Working by All Creatures. Hope you guys enjoyed this one.
We'll be right back. I've seen so many miracles, I forgot what the word impossible means. Raise hands to the sky, get your hopes up high, 'cause with God it's a regular thing. I've seen so many plot twists, I've stopped trying to guess how he's gonna move next. Just lean back with the lions, cook out in the fire, I don't have to be so stressed. Anytime it looks too hard, I've learned to lift my eyes to the stars, 'cause the maker of it all, he made my numbers on the scoreboard, listen to the crowd roar, you already know who wins. Anytime it looks too hard, I've learned to lift my eyes to the stars, 'cause the maker of it all, he made my heart, my heart.
Forgot what impossible mean. I'm telling you, when you in this word and in this truth,
yeah,
God just never ceases to amaze us. So many praise reports. All we have to do is just open our eyes.
That's all we got. That in our Save Fest coming up, testimony
night.
And we put that last because we might be going a while, y'all. So we like, OMG.
Your prayer to be amazed.
Yes, yes, yes.
That reminds me on Meet the Robinsons. I'm a Disney guru. But anyway, we put in the chat that if you guys wanted to read up, actually, I got it right here. 2 Kings 11, chapter 11. And I just wanted to tell you guys about the, if you go to verse 6, about how they were guarding the baby Joash at the time. At verse 6, this was Jehoiada giving the commandment, where he said, at verse 5 actually, this is the thing that ye shall do. A third part of you that enter in this inn on the Sabbath shall even be keepers of the watch of the king's house. Mm-hmm. And a third part shall be at the gate of Sur, and at the third part at the gate behind the guard. So shall ye keep the watch of the house, that it be not broken down. See, and two parts of you that go forth on the Sabbath, even they shall keep the watch of the house of the Lord about the king. So this is your first account of this is what we call bodyguards. And so that whole chapter, you guys can read, you know, just the story, how it unfolds of Joash and how he became to be the king, and how they had to dethrone Athaliah because she was just out of order. She was out of order. But thanks be to God for Jehoshabeth, the Jehoiada's wife, who was very instrumental in securing his future and for the future King of our Lord Jesus, who came in the flesh.
Amen.
Amen. So just wanted to give you guys that scripture. So moving on in our happy Sabbath day hour, happy Sabbath day show. If you're listening and just tuning in, we are now getting into our Body of Christ ministry shout outs. These are the ministries that are professing the Lord and teaching his word, putting that work in, putting that work in.
Yeah.
And Brother Isaiah, the evangelist,
right now. Yeah.
It comes on at 9:30 now, 9:30 a.m. Central Standard Time. The title, I love, I just got to act this title out. Yo, spirit is show is ugly. I got to do that like that.
To God.
Oh, from the color purple. I still didn't see the new color purple, but anyway, that's, you know, when she say, you show is ugly, but guess what? There is some spiritual ugliness that happens in our walk that we have to make sure we do not have, especially attending and approaching the Passover that's coming up. Okay?
Right.
So we want to make sure that we tune into that lesson. If you're not able to watch it now, of course, that's why we have these social media streaming platforms so that you can
go back and check it out from the top.
Yeah, so you got Facebook. He is on Facebook, Israel Church of God in Christ. And it's a universal international church for all people, okay? Helping people, especially around this time, to examine yourself. It says that. Paul tells us that
in
Corinthians. Examine yourself so we make sure that we're worthy to partake of the Passover.
Amen.
So moving on in our ministry shadows, Bible Christians Fellowship of the Spirit. Woo. We missed you guys, Bible chat last Sabbath. Anyway. So we're going to have a lesson by Brother Isaiah Israel today. It's going to be called Humble and Meek, Exalted by God. And I love the picture there. They have some beautiful pictures to show when they have their lessons, because it's a picture. What do they say? A picture is worth a thousand words.
Yeah.
Look at how they got the man there is humbled and kneeling down before God. You know, the sun shining in his face. Just, you know. Oh, we need more meditative moments like that. So tune into the lesson to get today, guys, at 2 p.m. Central Standard Time, 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on the streaming platforms, YouTube and Facebook. Also, the dialogue chat is back. So it's going to be, they're keeping it at the same time, guys. So I know we have the time change that happened, but usually they go an hour up, but they're going to keep it at this 4 o'clock Central Standard Time. So if you're able to join in, please join in. We learn so much with these chats. And today's chat is every wind of doctrine. Again, look at the pictorial. Look at the art right there. Look at all the different colors and even the different ways that the people are facing. Think about that for a moment, because that's what we're living in today. So every wind of doctrine is today, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time. Check it out. Check it out. You may even have a question about how you, someone approached you, a doctrine or a question that they had. And you have to be always ready to give a reason, for the reason of the hope. And also they have on Fridays at 8 p.m. Central Standard Time, their dialogue chats. If you'd like to join in on those chats, you know, make sure you get in contact with Sister Brit. She's here. She can give you the Zoom information. And anybody from the Bible Christian Fellowship of the Spirit, we'd love to have you on as a guest there. And it's more private and discussions and topics, things that you want to
just... She just put out that this is the brothers' chat for today.
The brothers. Go, brothers. Go, brothers.
Okay. Open invite? Hold on. Is this an open invite? Is this an open invite?
Oh, I do say that. It's right there on the... And I got my glasses on. So join us today for our discussion with the brothers.
Amen. Okay.
With the brothers. Amen for that. She said, LOL, I don't know.
Yeah, because that's... I mean, it could be just the brothers of Bible Christians Fresh Up with the Spirit.
Yeah,
or
probably Brother Isaiah.
Yeah, probably will make it a little more plainer. When you say open, then that's beyond the members. Yeah, just for clarity's sake, whenever you put something out publicly, it's a good thing to say open. That way, don't nobody think, well, this is probably something they're conducting within ministry. That's all I'm saying.
Amen.
Yeah, okay.
All right, so tune in today, every Wednesday of Doctrine, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time, 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Amen.
Every Wednesday of Doctrine. So many out here. And then also the House of Light Ministries with Brother Duell, Brother Nathaniel will be teaching a lesson today entitled, If God Were to Test Your Heart, What Would He Find?
Wow, I hope he found saved and found born again and found a, woo, that's a good one, y'all.
Hope you find the truth.
Yes.
The spiritual truth. Hope you find meekness, humbleness.
Yeah, new creature.
And look at this. Look at the background of this, the picture. You see there's a test.
Yes.
Are you going to pass? You see the Scantron? You got a bubble it in. A, B, what's your answer choice? What's your answer to this? That's today. If you are in the area, in the Georgia area, there is the information
and
by
online,
which you could go.
Yes.
Yeah, all the streaming platforms, YouTube, the website there, House of Light Ministry. House of Light Truth, .com or .org. And then there's Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok. So should be a very great lesson for today.
Amen.
If God were to test your heart, what would he find? Because remember, he said that our heart is.
He said, I'll give you a new heart that you can walk in my statutes.
That's right.
Commandments.
But it is deceitfully wicked. Who can know it? Jeremiah tells
The heart is
deceitfully wicked.
Who can know? That's why we
God knows
new
it.
Heart. That's right. That's why he gives us a new heart to
and
walk
so
in.
And so people need to stop saying, but God knows my heart. Yeah, he knows it, and he knows we need to fix it.
That's why he gives us a new one in Ezekiel. He'll tell you. So this
is a new heart.
Very interesting topic.
And then that's what Psalm says, too. Yes. Creating me a clean heart.
Yes.
Pure
new
heart.
Right spirit within me. Amen.
Yeah. That kind of goes into the IGS lesson. Because you got a Christ about this, your spirit is so ugly.
Yes.
Because if your heart ain't right, that's also spiritual.
Oh, yeah.
So we got some great lessons. Great lessons on the Sabbath.
Yes, indeed.
The food that we need to make sure that we are fed. Ministry shout outs, we got the Congregation of the Law and Testimony, Brother Robert Slayton. And if I'm not sure if he's joining us on our AM show, but I'm not sure what his topic today would be.
Yeah.
But his lessons are on YouTube.
Yes.
He can also be a featured ministry on our Sade Fest, along with Bible Christian Fellowship of the Spirit and other guests. But
and today, Preacher Head Ministry, they're doing Body of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so you can tune in to that. He comes on Friday at 9 p.m. Central Standard Time, and also on the Sabbath at 3 p.m. Central Standard Time. There's also the Body of Christ, the One of Us, Overcoming Evil with Good.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a great understanding, because sometimes your body want to be reactive and you want to just lash out at people, and understand that that's part of the fruit of the Spirit, temperance, being able to temper your anger, temper your impulses, because sometimes you want to just say the first thing to come out of your mouth or react, you know, physically, you know, to what people say.
Mm-hmm.
And it's important that we overcome evil with good. And it's so difficult. I get it. And then also the House of Spiritual Israel, Brother John Pappas.
Yeah, trying to get his times. I think he came on last night. Yeah, I'm not seeing nothing now.
Yeah. So he has a more, fluctuating schedule, which is fine, because whenever the Spirit moves you to do a lesson, and I also think he has a work schedule as well, but you can also find him on the Facebook as well. That's House of Spiritual Israel. And then also we have Oz of Fingers.
Mm-hmm. Wake Up Show.
The Wake Up Show. I can't wait to see how he talk about this Easter.
Oh, God.
Unthinkable. First, it was Sister Marlise from, she showed us over in her area because she's, I hope she don't
mind.
And
it's over here.
I hope she don't mind us mentioning, but she's over there in Switzerland, and how last year, that was the first time we ever seen Easter trees. What, eggs hanging from trees?
Wow!
And then I look at my neighborhood.
Yeah.
And I see, I have to immediately take a picture because I'm like, oh my goodness, this is a thing?
Come on,
this
y'all.
This is really a thing.
Come on, y'all.
With the Easter trees. And what does that have to do with Jesus? Just like the Christmas trees have nothing to do with Jesus. And so now we're seeing this trend of all these holidays just putting all these idols and stuff on getting, these trees. And this is tree worship.
Yeah, it's getting,
tree worship. So anyway, it's just.
Oh yeah,
it's not looking.
Yeah, it's getting.
We gotta pray. We gotta pray. Yeah. But anyway, I am happy to and glad to see how Brother Ozzie Fingers take out the history on that and showcase. He goes in depth with these holidays and show the history and even put the biblical scriptures together with that because we know in Jeremiah it talks about Astarte, the Queen of Heaven.
Yeah.
These are things that was all the way in the BC era, in BC times.
Yeah.
So, so with that being said, we want to thank God. Let's give a Lord praise for all of the body parts, the men and women that's putting the word of God forth. And then we're in Isaiah Scriptures Corner. And Isaiah Scriptures Corner, we want to talk about Psalms 31:5.
Yeah. Look at that. Into thy hand I commit my spirit.
Yes.
Thou hast redeemed me, O Lord God of truth.
Wow.
Amazing.
So when you're dealing with all this other stuff, you ain't been redeemed by the God of truth.
Yes. Amen. Amen. So my hand has to be
Yes.
That's a humility.
Yes.
You have to be humbled.
Yes.
Yes.
Redeemed by the Lord God of truth.
Yes. Amen. So that's our Isaiah Scripture Corner for today.
Yeah.
And remember, if you have any scriptures that you'd like to submit to the AM show, please do so in the chat right now, perhaps for next week.
Yep.
Or also get in contact with me, myself, or Brother Jacob, and we will put that scripture because there are so many scriptures that empower us, that inspire us. And we just want to share with the body of Christ. We just want to share with the body of Christ. Before we get into our Bible trivia, let's put up some more, another gospel praise, another gospel praise. Let's get into our comments. Happy Sabbath. Cheryl Watson, grace and peace. Glad you're able to join us. Woo, woo.
Yes.
Sis Haddock's Blessed said, Easter trees are crazy. No way. Yes.
Yeah.
And you know what? I'm going to see if I could try to bring a picture up. If not this show. Definitely for next week, so you can see. That. I mean, I am not making this up. Yeah, I'm like, And then we thought we seen it all with the Christmas trees, but then even the Valentine's Day trees. At my appointment, it was right on the desk there, and I'm just like, I took a picture of that too. So we're living, like Brother Chris said, tree worship is real. Yeah. Shaking my head, yes, and people don't even realize.
Yeah.
That's what that is.
Yeah.
So we're going to get into a gospel praise. This is Ryan Ellis, Perfect Peace. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. Ryan Ellis, Perfect Peace. Because that's what we need in this day and age when we see all this tree worship. We need that perfect peace to calm us down so we don't act out of impulse, right?
Okay.
So this is Ryan Ellis, Perfect Peace.
Can I go with all the hurt when my whole world is crashing down? What can I do when I can't breathe and all I see are valleys now? I find it hard to speak, and my heart just won't believe. I feel you standing next to me, next to me. You keep me in perfect peace. You keep me. I'm finding you're all I need. God, you keep me in perfect peace. I cast my cares at your feet, knowing you won't let me down. And I will rest where I belong, here with you where I am found. Oh, you keep me in perfect peace. You keep me in perfect peace. I find in you all I need. You keep me in perfect peace, and your love is lifting my hope, and your love is healing my soul. Everything broken.
Lord, I worship you because of who. because of what you've done, but because
of who you are, I give you praise.
Because of who you are.
Perfect peace scripture always remind me of my favorite scripture in Isaiah 26:3. Thou will keep him in perfect peace.
Yes.
Whose mind is staying on thee because he trusted in thee.
Yes, indeed. Amen. Keep you.
Oh, come on. In perfect peace.
Come on.
That's like a promise.
Yeah.
It's a promise. It's God's promise.
And it
said,
let God be true, but every man or what?
Liar. Amen.
Oh,
amen. So happy Sabbath, Brother Robert Slate. We were just talking about you. If you could put your lesson today of where you'll be talking about on the YouTube, it would be greatly appreciated. He said, love you all, and we love you as well, brother. Man. Sister Betty said, thank God for perfect peace in the midst of whatever is going on in our lives. Only God can do that. Thank you, Lord. 3 exclamation points. You better say it. Better say it. Amen. Happy Sabbath. Brother Elijah, glad you could join us. Happy Sabbath. Happy Sabbath. Sister Betty said, hallelujah. Hand praises in the air. Yes. Music emojis.
Yes.
Praise your holy name. Yes. Jesus, thank you, Jesus. G-L-O-R-Y. Glory. Glory. A cat.
Woo.
#Focus #AmenLights. Praise God for you, brother, in Jesus' name.
So what took us a little long is we wanted to bring this up because this is really
we were talking about we were staying in the landscape. If you're just joining us, and we were sharing, some of the brothers and sisters were sharing their what was around them, their observations, since we're coming into this
heathenism.
You say heathenism. I said paganism. Same thing.
Yeah.
But nevertheless, we are as bodies of Christ and saints of God are preparing for the Passover.
Yes.
But the picture we wanted to show, we were talking about the Easter trees and the chats. And this is what I just seen recently this last Wednesday at my grocery store. There is a flower, as you guys can see, and then there are eggs with the tree, with the bird. Well, at least they got that birds lay eggs. At least we didn't see the bunny rabbits in there.
No.
But still, this is my first time seeing, you know, that's a little floral department, the floral department. But they have these trees, these little plants, and they have eggs inside the trees. This whole little Easter display.
Right.
And there's the cookies on the left side and all this other stuff. But I've never have seen this all my living. And you got, and for some of you guys are that are even older than I am, you could place in the chat whether this is your first time seeing,
okay,
you know, displays such as this. Because I'm telling you, I've never seen this. But, and then even for...
But, yeah, go ahead.
From our, even across the pond, from my dear sister Marlise, who's also on the horizon of looking at these observations from Germany, from Switzerland. Yeah. This is what she sent us, a picture.
Now, this is local, right? This is a picture local.
No, the one that you're going to, the next picture you're going to show.
We got one in our neighborhood we'll show next week, but watch this show.
But the one that Sister Marlise, this is from Germany.
Look at this.
This is one, she was just traveling.
Eggs on a tree?
In her neighborhood. This is in her neighborhood.
Eggs? Dangling from the tree?
I've never seen this.
Never. That.
And I was saying, I said, the day we start seeing Easter trees, I was saying that, last year or 2 years ago.
And we got one around the corner. We had that picture for next. Yeah. We're right here in Houston, Texas. So if y'all got some pictures of these, send them in. We would display them.
It's an open display of what's happening.
Like, wow.
What's happening in our... And it's so smooth. It's so subtle because people don't even realize this is tree worship.
Because I'm like, hold on. Eggs hanging on a tree. That's how I'd get out.
Yeah. Brother Chris, I've never seen it before.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah,
this definitely, this is new.
Yeah.
And they don't even realize it's just the perpetuation of keeping this tree up all year round. I mean, I used to be like, oh, what are we going to see next? Valentine's tree, oh, what are we going to see next? Easter trees. Yeah. We're in this time.
Yeah.
And this is the time for us brothers and sisters to start praying for people and start putting the truth out there because I know on the social media, I'm not on there a lot. I try not to because I put myself in time out. Like, I can't.
Oh,
I got
my God.
On the rest of the things that I got to do.
Yeah.
But I, put that Ishtar photo in there with this picture of the Easter trees and it's giving the people the knowledge, the background. Yeah. Like, we can't do this.
Yeah. So
this is not permissible.
That's why I commend my spirit into thy hands.
Yes.
O Lord God of truth. Amen. Yes. God has redeemed me from that.
Yes.
Yes, he has.
Sister Betty also said, never in all my life have I seen eggs on tree.
On a tree. See? That right there.
See? Yes.
That right there.
And even Brother Chris, he said, any way for the merchants to get rich. And that's really what it is.
Oh my
He said, they'll
God.
Craft new ways to serve their gods. And that's what we're in. That's the age that we're in now. It's all about the money. And immediately after Valentine's Day, the very next day I was in the store and they had the stocks full of Easter stuff. I mean, they had the overnight crew working, had to been, because I was just in the store the previous day. I forgot something at the start to go back the next day. And I'm like,
next day, they be flipping it like.
And you know what I put on the social media? Took a picture. I said, and the programming continues.
Yeah.
It's all about the money, and it's always keeping you with the next best thing, the next thing, the next thing, the next thing, the next thing. And so we have to keep our eyes open, brothers and sisters, too.
Screenshot that one, y'all. That right there. But like I said, it's one in our neighborhood near where we live. Like,
I'm like, honey. But I'm not surprised about that family because I seen when Christmas came, when they Halloween, they had a whole 15-foot
skeleton.
Giant. I mean, it was
giant Halloween crap out there.
It went way out.
Wow.
It's out here, family. It's out here. It's out here. So let's warn our brothers and sisters. Let's tell them that this is not of God. None of it.
No shape, form, or fashion.
Amen. Yeah, so we could try to save some of these people out of
idolatry.
That's what it is, idolatry.
Yeah. I get that. I've probably seen something close to that. Maybe. But that right there. Mm-mm.
Wow.
Okay. Right?
All right, so moving on to our Bible trivia.
All right.
Our Bible trivia, get your Bibles, your pen and paper, iron sharpen iron.
What did the book say?
Yes, not what the man say.
Yeah, not what your pastor said.
What the book say, what the book say. All about the Bible.
Okay, y'all.
Amen.
Yeah. Oh, Brother Chris said, anyway, for the, okay, and one just popped up. If it's because I don't keep these things anymore, but it seems like they're really going over the top nowadays.
Yes, so true, Sister Hattie. Absolutely. Yes. It's like the next best thing, the greatest.
Trying to get one up on trying to one up
anything
everything.
They could do to try to be the first up, of anything.
Or one up.
Yeah. You know, just new ways to try to get money. Yep. Like, oh, they didn't think of this.
Right.
Now, oh my gosh, a thought just came to my head.
Uh-oh.
Now, what if they have LGBT trees?
Oh.
You heard it here first. No.
Yeah. Come on. Let's not give the heathens any ideas.
Oh my gosh. Imagine that.
Yeah, imagine that.
Oh my gosh. That's like twice dead.
Yeah. Dead now.
Yeah, I hope not.
Anyway. Bible trivia. Let's get it.
What's the first question? Oh yes. Timer. Mm-hmm. Let's see what we got today. We got up to two. Let's do 2 minutes.
We having the same blank.
I believed, and therefore have I spoken.
Mm-hmm.
We also believe, and therefore speak.
Mm-hmm.
What did the book say?
We having the same bloodline of our fathers, according as it is written. Be spirit of faith, according as it is popular. See, spirit of faith, according as our pastor has said. Or D, spirit of faith, according as it is written.
Amen. So, answer question number one as we put this gospel praise, let's put the gospel praise mix, or are you doing?
We're going to put some music on.
All right, so we're going to get the Amazing by Ricky Dillard as you guys answer question number one. Let's go. Sister Betty, Brother Chris, Sister Hattie, Sister Shara, Kalani. Happy Sabbath, Kalani. Wish they you.
Oh, yeah.
Nyla and Brother Chris has written the scriptural reference, 2 Corinthians 4:13. Yeah. They have said the Spirit of God, the saints of God has spoken. They say it's the spirit of faith according as it is written.
Is
it
right? Yay.
Yes, that's
all right,
right.
All right.
Right.
That's what we got to do, y'all.
That's what we got to say.
That's what the book said.
We having the same
spirit
of
faith according as it is
written,
y'all. Not popular. What my pastor said.
No.
Brother Jacob said.
None. No. I believe.
Dang.
And therefore have I spoken.
Spoken.
Yes.
We also believe.
Yes.
And therefore what?
Speak. Yes.
All right, our next one.
Next question. Our Bible trivia. The second question is,
mm-hmm. For with blank will he speak to this people?
Hmm.
Hmm. Stammering lips in another tongue, A.
Mm-hmm. B. Ancient Greek and Hebrew.
Hmm. C. Paleo Hebrew, not English. Oh.
And D, none of the above. Hmm. All right, saints. To some, this is a very easy question.
Yeah, yeah.
So let's get it. Let's bring back the gospel praise as we answer. For with blank will he speak to this people. Let's go, saints.
For you're my keeper. You're my deliverer.
With Isaiah 28:11, Brother Chris there. But with stammering lips and another tongue, will he speak to this people? KJV. Mm-hmm. Sister Betty Sue West said, really?
Dang.
Brother Jacob, she want me to lay the holy, holy, holy hand. Holy, holy, Jesus, Jesus. See, even Sister Hattie had to, had the laughing emojis with the crying out loud emojis.
Okay.
Because Paleo Hebrew.
Come on, y'all.
Really?
I know.
Really?
I know.
She said, never know what people will come to you with, so they believe it too.
Yep.
And
yep.
Brother Elijah also got the laughing emoji. And
yeah,
Sister
Britt,
we got to have the holy hand. I'm going to have an actual holy hand. I'm going to have a glove next time for you. Okay. So the answer, brother, was sisters.
Come on, y'all. We kind of.
We got it.
Because
there are some boxes.
Yeah, you got people out there like,
Yeah.
Wow.
That you need to speak Hebrew.
Yeah, that you walk in the church and English is outside and not inside.
Yeah, and so it's the reason why these questions is coming up for the edification for us, so that we can get these scriptures and share with people. You know, God is a God of all people.
Yes.
Nationalities. Yes. Didn't he say he died for all people?
His house will be a house of prayer for all people.
All people. Come on. Isaiah 56. And then he also, you know, the same John 3:16, for God so loved the world and he gave his only begotten son.
That whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
Everlasting life.
Come on, y'all.
Who does whosoever come?
Anybody left out?
Anybody left out?
Mm.
So,
well, we ride along.
And I love our family. We are family of
And how hear we every man blank born?
Oh.
Mm. In Hebrew, wherein they were born? Go.
What's up with these Hebrew questions?
Damn. B. In our own tongue, wherein we were born?
C. In another tongue, wherein no one was born? Or D. None of the above?
Hmm.
All right, all right. We're going to get some more gospel music playing as you guys answer number three. And how hear we every man blank born? Amen.
All right. Here we go.
Here we go, saints.
That I could take it all back. I just want to tell him that. Tell him that I got off track. I made mistakes. Backslid my way into that place where souls get lost, lines get crossed, and the pain won't go away. I hit my knees. Now here I stand. There I was. Now here I am.
Change.
Oh yeah.
By Rascal Flatts.
Man.
But the question at hand on the Bible trivia today, as you're listening to the Happy Sabbath Day AM show, says, and how hear we every man? And all of our listening audience has put the letter B with the scripture reference. Even Kalani say it keeps removing the KJV for me. Oh my God, we rebuke it.
Wow.
Rebuke that computer in Jesus' name.
Hmm.
Get that, trying to let
So what
know.
Did the book say?
Everybody got access to the name. Let's go, let's go. What's it say? What's it say? What's
When every man in our own tongue wherein we were what? Born. That's what it said. That's what the book says. That's what the book says. Wherein we were born. So, amen, I got to run over there and down on Hebrew. Yeah. Give me some Greek in the end.
And that's something, even when John 5:28, marvel not at this, that every man
Every tongue is going to confess.
And she'll hear his voice.
Yeah, every tongue.
In the grave.
Yes. Hmm, how many languages is in the grave?
Uh-oh.
Oh, my God.
Ooh. Yeah.
Especially that of Adam name.
Okay.
We don't know what language that was.
Okay.
Adamese. Adamlish. Instead of Adam-ish. Adamlish. Adamlish. Adamish. I don't know.
Adamish. Yeah. Adam. Anyway.
It was Adamese.
Oh, yeah. How about that?
Anyway, so that's Acts 2.
Yeah.
And verse 8, brothers and sisters, you got it right on the head. Praise God. Okay. Praise Amen. God. Amen. Praise God. You have a bonus today.
We done that.
We'd like to thank everybody. Thank you for participating in the Bible trivia. If you did not know any of the questions, hey, we're all here to learn and edify one another.
Yes.
And if you did know it, and hey, it's just a reminder, that's great as well, because it is our job to go out and teach whole nations, like he told the disciples. And if we are followers of Christ, that is exactly what we're here to do, to make sure that we are giving people a reason for the hope. They may ask you, why are you not dealing with Easter? What's wrong with you?
Why are you not hanging eggs on trees? Oh.
No, don't start.
Anyway, yeah.
But they may ask, why are you not going to... Or you might get an invitation for the Resurrection Sunday service.
Yeah, how about that?
The Resurrection Sunday service.
So why ain't hanging eggs on...
No.
I'm sorry.
But I even have a sign.
And we do have a tree in front of our house. I wish somebody would walk up to our house of mine. Why y'all hang it?
No.
Oh.
But you know what? I'm finna go get my sign.
Let's go get Sabby. She'll probably tell
me. I'm gonna get my sign that I'm thinking about, you know, should I be at the malls this time? Or should we just hang out by the bus stop? So there are several signs that we have when we go and evangelize to try to awaken the people. With that being said, moving on in our show, in the Happy Sabbath Day AM show.
Annie, here we go, Annie.
Annie ain't got nothing to do with it.
Yeah, she got everything. She down there tickling my toes.
That's the dog. Anyway, so our second annual Save Fest, it is here. It's coming in the next few days.
Yes, it is.
A lot of people have asked, what is the Save Fest?
So when you hear that music, y'all, you already know what's going down.
I want you guys to be there in Square 17. It's a virtual event. It is a virtual event with the following ministry.
Yeah, we're gonna talk about that. process.
Yes.
These ministries are going to really bring it, y'all. We're going to bring it. We're going to bring it. Oh, yeah. So that's what the theme night is going to be for every night, y'all.
So here right we go. There. We got the first night, Sunday night. Ooh, ooh. Saved from what?
Yeah.
And saved to what?
Oh, yeah.
He always saved Israel from something. But he gave them something to do.
That's right.
So even now, when God took us from whatever we were, whether it was Baptist, I don't know, Buddha, Egyptology, there's a lot of doctrines out here. Which is why Bible Christian Fellowship of Spirit going to talk about that every land of doctrine.
How about that?
So he saved us from some kind of foolishness. But then once he did that, now it's like, okay, what is the job? What is the mission?
Yes.
Right? So that's going to be the first night. And then the second night is the preserve, right? When you think about preservation, it's a feeling. You got to maintain something. It's, it's making sure that we don't get this molding, you know, that green.
Yes. Ooh, it's that protection.
Just like Brother Isaiah blessed today, the ugly, make sure your spirit ain't ugly. When you think about mold, that's not pretty. It even smells bad, doesn't smell good. And then also for the third night we got the Tuesday thing, which is we are one in Christ. Which will be the daughters of Zion, and talking about the women involvement and how they too helped in that way. Okay.
And then the last night, the big night, look.
Oh, and let's not forget on that Tuesday, it's that testimony.
Oh, yeah, Oh, yeah.
So that's going to be explosive.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God.
So we got some powerful, impactful testimonies that's going to be on that Tuesday night that shares about the salvation.
Oh,
and
yeah.
What, how God has taken them from where they were and has restored them.
Oh, yeah.
And the last night, the agenda of God.
Versus Satan's agenda, that dialogue is y'all.
Yes. If you're not aware of Satan's devices, because that's what's the most thing.
Oh, yeah.
We are aware.
Oh, yeah. You want to
be aware. We are not ignorant of Satan's devices. But we can't be walking around ignorant and falling victim to all these traps, booby traps. You can't call Ghostbusters, nor can you call Avengers or superheroes. This is a spiritual warfare that we're fighting. So if you've never heard of Satan's devices, you want to tune in for that night. Amen. For the whole entire thing. And this is the theme. We got the dialogue chats. We got the different ministries that are becoming one. And this is a great event to showcase the glory of God. So that's what it's all about. Not ourselves, not our flesh, but what God has done for us. And we are grateful that he didn't leave us. Remember Ezekiel 16 when it said Israel was waddling in that blood and nobody wanted to take care of her. God has taken care of us. God has swaddled us. God has brought us back to health. Ezekiel 37, he breathed into our bones. He breathed that breath of righteousness in our bones.
This ministry right there going to bring it.
So we're glad that that is come. We are at that weekend. We are here. We are here tomorrow night. It's tomorrow night, and we're grateful and thankful to God for being put this together for the glory of God. So we pray that you guys can join us. Share and like, of course, so that other people can hear. We can save souls even in the same path.
Your mother, your brother,
or your cousin, you may be struggling with something, they may be sick, they may be hurt. This is a way to get them into the truth.
And these ministries
the
is going to bring it, y'all. Again, Israel Church of God in Christ. Israel, actually his street ministry name is True Israel of God. Israel God of Mixed Multitude. Official name of it, Bible Christian Fellowship of the Spirit. Congregation on Law and Testimony, and Bible Christians of God. Amen.
Amen. So looking forward to that. If you are telling God that we are, as we glorify God, and His truth. That's what it's all about. So moving on also with our community corner for the community, making sure that I'm sorry, not community corner. The Sabbath movie choice.
Yes.
Yes, so this is the last series that we have talked about. So this three-part series is a movie series. And it started with Remember the Goal.
Yes.
Then the second movie was The Perfect Race.
Yes.
And then now it's Always a Winner.
Yes.
Okay, and so this movie here is a girl that transfers to a Christian school. That's the one that's in the red to the left. She's, for her senior year, determined to repeat as state golf champion. As she begins that quest, she is greatly affected by her golf coach and comes to learn what is really most important in life, because she kind of comes with this arrogant type of spirit. And, well, I'm the champion, so I even beat your record, coach. You know, so it's a really good movie to showcase just some of the struggles that the teens go through in that high school era. And then not only just the teens, but even as coaches or people that are in authority that have, influence. We should have the positive influence on young people's lives. And because it is a Christian school or university, they are also reminded what role that God plays in their life.
Yes.
Okay. So it's a great movie. Of course, it's on the streaming platforms. YouTube, I believe this one is on YouTube as well,
mm-hmm.
as the other two movies. So if you missed the other two movies mm-hmm. that coincide with this whole storyline,
check them out.
Coach,
check them out.
Family, love, humility, joy in God, all of those themes that are in this movie. So Always a Winner, because that's what God wants us to be.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
We gotta be winners.
Amen.
All right?
Yeah.
And even if we feel like we fail, we still have to stay faithful.
Yeah. And he had the process to what? Lift us up where we what?
Belong.
Amen. Amen.
Lift us up where we belong. Amen. And Brother Chris said, good viewing. We enjoyed the first two in the series.
Amen.
Glad for that feedback, Brother Chris. And so in our community corner, we've been just promoting this reading.
Oh,
March is the National Reading Month. And so if you'd like to have a book for the family that you're reading chapters together, or a regular, just a regular book, it could be the Bible. Obviously, we're always promoting the Bible.
Oh, yeah, you got that right.
Because last week when I was just searching up the woman that wanted to showcase for the AM show, I ended up reading like 3 or 4 chapters outside of Jehoshabeth, which is Jehoiada's wife. I was all the way into after Joash and then what happened with him when he was king. And then I just got into a whole nother. It just takes you into that mode of just like, as a reminder, because I read these those stories years ago about the kings, but it's really, the Bible is full of mystery, drama, weddings, war, right?
Yes.
Love, all the fruits of the Spirit, God, mercy, and grace.
Beginning, end, today, and now.
Yes,
stuff happening right now.
Yeah.
So it covers the whole
end time prophecies
throughout
the Old and New Testament.
Yeah. Come on, y'all.
So it's a great thing to read, amongst each other. Sometimes it's taking a break from those devices. The computers and your phones. Aww. And just sit back and relax. So March is National Reading Month.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So that's what we have in our community corner. Yes. So moving on from there. Also, Bible Christians interactive Saturday class. This is for everybody, every kid that wants to learn about God. Even if you're not in any one of these classes or camps, churches, if your child wants to learn about God and have a genuine heart to want to learn and understand the Word,
we strongly
encourage the families to register. We're just ending ABIB, because this is kind of new for a lot of people, understanding the real new year and what that means. And how do you, even for the older kids, determining ABIB with those three factors, the equinox, the new moon, as well as the vegetation. So they are understanding that, and they're able to explain that, understanding that ABIB is God's first new year. But guess what? In that first year, and being that ABIB is the first month, guess what? That's the creation.
Yeah.
In that first month, he created those things in those first 6 days. So we've used.
We're still, the creation is still in AB.
Yeah, we're stuck in the repeated cycle.
Yeah, we ain't got a.
Day six, because we know day seven has not gotten here yet. Yeah. So the kids are having a wonderful, wonderful time learning about Abib and those creation days.
Yeah.
For the younger kids, we got the mini creation booklet, and they're having a great time with the links that we provide, these other websites that show like God's nature underwater with that day five. We just ended with day five and six, which is the water creatures as well as the land creatures.
Mm-hmm.
And even for the older kids, helping them to understand the scripture that talks about those land animals, the dietary restrictions with Deuteronomy 11.
Yeah.
And highlighting that in their Bible, because they're getting at that stage where they hanging out with their teens and at the malls and stuff. And they're like, hey, does that got pork in it? So understanding how animals was, you know, affects our diet and what we eat.
Oh, yeah.
And spiritual knowledge of, hey, I can't eat that because of this scripture.
Yeah.
And so for the older kids, they're putting together their PowerPoint presentations, and I'm excited to see what they put together because these kids are really smart.
Wow!
Soldiers for Christ. And that's the aim, to help them to be soldiers for Christ. And I just want to thank the parents who have dedicated and committed to allowing their kids to be a part of this. Without you, the help, the technology support that requires to have you be a tab on your phone, and then making sure that they're prepared with their Bibles and their notebooks and stuff like that. So if you are wanting to be a part of this interactive Saturday class, they're having so much fun with music and song and praise on the Sabbath. Register now if you would like. If even you don't have children, but you think someone else will be interested, send us the email, there's contact information in the chat box below, and we'll get you the registration form.
Mm-hmm.
And so that they also could partake of this learning, because next month we're going to be talking about the Passover.
Yes.
Now that's very important. Passover and the Feast of Unleavened Bread. But we know that Abib
They're still babies, y'all. I know they
still. Yes. Okay. They're my babies.
Oh my God.
I love them. I love the kids. I'll be on there sometime so late.
Look,
and then we got one more question. So again, that is the Sabbath Day Bright Learners. All program. Children are welcome from the ages of seven. Even if you're younger than seven and you have that parent support and all, or older siblings, who will
so they go to age again.
Yeah.
7 through 9 for the first class, and then 10 and above.
Yes.
After what? That's 8 o'clock.
Yeah, 8 p.m. Central Standard Time. And we're having a wonderful time with that.
All right.
So moving on, with our lesson today, we are introducing the Save Fest. This is the introduction to the Save Fest. So the lesson that's introducing the Save Fest is also inspired by the scripture Psalm 71:3. Be thou my strong habitation, whereunto I might continually resort. That means rest, by the way. Thou hast given commandment
to save me.
Wow!
It's a commandment for God to save.
Wow. So
did y'all know that was in the scripture?
That's why we should be flooded. We shouldn't even have enough room.
For thou art my rock and my fortress.
Amen. We believe God can get that commandment. We believe.
It's a promise.
Oh, come on, y'all.
It's a promise. And we need to stand on the promises of God. I'm waiting for that lesson.
Yeah, come on, y'all.
Put that lesson together, bro, Jacob. The promises of God.
Yeah, well, we're looking at one of them.
And how oftentimes do we see in the scripture, guys, they crying out, Lord, save me.
He's giving
every last one of us has been in our wits' end. Yes. And don't worry, if you haven't been there, like Les Brown said, he said either you just left a problem, you in a problem, or you headed to a problem. So, we all have been, and don't worry if you haven't, that's okay for some of our younger audiences. But, you know,
Yeah.
We have all been there where we're like, Lord, please save me. I need you now. With Smokey Norfolk, his son.
I need you. Oh, hey,
Come on, Brother Jacob. Need you now.
Come on, y'all. Okay.
I need you now. Yeah, so we should play that.
You're going to get it in. Because I actually have people say, what is a Save Fest? So,
yeah.
This is for you. Yeah. This is for you.
It's a great way to honor and acknowledge God. Yes. Because too often we're complaining. Too often we're just begging God, God, please, please, please. Yeah. But what about giving the praise to God? So that, it's a praise fest. If everybody, it is a fest to praise God.
Yes.
So we're going to be acknowledging the things that he's done over the years.
And for keeping that commandment for me.
Yes, because that was his promise.
Amen.
We have to believe that he's going to do that. And I think that was Israel's biggest problem.
Oh, that won't come out. Flesh issues?
Think about it. When you come out as a baby, you're like, I don't know if I'm going to come out. I don't trust the world. We're born into this mistrust. But anyway, thank God for his saving grace. And guess what? As a newborn baby, like little physical newborn baby, you got to trust your parents. You trust that they're going to nurture you and supply your needs and get your food and your nurturing and your love and your swaddling.
Yeah.
And as you grow as a toddler in the elementary age and even a teen, you're still relying on that comfort, that promise. Like, I promise to not leave you out here distressed. God will not leave us in our distress. Okay?
Okay.
And Brother Elijah Israel says,
Oh God, the Lord, thou hast covered my head. Thou hast covered my head.
Sorry about that. Sister Hattie has the laughing emojis there. Yeah. We're talking about the mistrust. Yeah. That we have as a people.
Oh, we got trust issues.
All right, so that's today's lesson in the Bible Quizzes of God, the introduction to the Save Fest. And then also on tomorrow, the first day of the week session, Bible Truth Hour, if you have any questions that you'd like to present, maybe a question that one of your coworkers or your family asked you that you wanted to just have confirmation for.
Yeah.
And also the highlight is the seven errors of Sunday worship. This is a continuation from last Sunday.
Yeah.
So there are some errors that when we talk about people who are worshiping on a Sunday, they have these scriptures that they've used to support why they do what they do. But we have to go in and show them, no, that's not what the scripture is saying. Let's read it in context. So you may have some Sunday worshipers that are following error or falling victim to one of these errors. So let's make sure that we tune into this so that we can able to give them the instructions from the Word of God to help pull them out of that.
Yes.
And what does that do? That saves a soul.
That
converts the soul, as James talked about in the Bible. Yes. So that's 8 a.m. Central Standard Time. And I know that may be early for some of our brothers and sisters. But guess what? Because we have technology, and we are in the digital age, you can always go back and replay the lessons or the question and answers, because I always do. It's so many ministries throughout the week on the Sabbath. I always selectively go in and, you know, throughout the day, put it on a lesson as a podcast. I'm listening to it as I'm
throughout
cooking.
The week,
and I just, you know, every so many minutes, okay, it's going to start back tomorrow. We'll pick up where I left off at, and then all the way till I'm done with that lesson, and I just choose the next ministry as well. So we're getting it all in that you fortify yourself with the Word of God throughout the week. It's so important, brothers and sisters, to keep that Word in you.
Yes, it is.
And dwell in you.
Yes, it is.
So with that being said, brothers and sisters, we pray that you've had a wonderful, wonderful time with us on a happy Sabbath day AM show. Don't forget, we're here every Sabbath at 10 a.m. Central Standard Time. And we are glad you were able to join us. For those for you, if this is your first time, welcome. And if you are a repeated guest, still welcome, because we wouldn't have this show without you. Your input, your participation is always welcomed and glad to help lift God, because that's what it is. It's His way.
Yes, by glorifying Him.
Yes. And I get so tired of people complaining. Oh, and we don't really do nothing on Sabbath.
That's every day of delight and rejoicing.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
We are always glad for the Sabbath day.
Yes.
And yes. We just want to.
And when you know what it's headed for,
yes.
Oh, this is most definitely a day to delight in.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
And so make sure you tune into the ministries that we have promoted and put out there for you guys to listen to feed your soul on the Sabbath day. And not just on the Sabbath day, but throughout the week, that you may glorify in the word in truth.
Yes.
And as we get ready to sign off,
happy, happy Sabbath day. Happy, happy Sabbath day. Happy, happy Sabbath day. Happy, happy Sabbath day. Feliz, feliz Sabbath day. Feliz, feliz Sabbath day. Feliz, feliz Sabbath day.
The latest news.